Hello, and welcome to Folger Encores. I'm Erin Weaver, and I'm excited to be able to speak with you today. The Folger has been sharing selections from their plays, music, talks, and readings with you in this encore series. This week, we're revisiting the Folger Theatre production of Sense and Sensibility, based on Jane Austen's novel, adapted by Kate Hamill and directed by Eric Tucker, with choreography by Alexandra Beller. In this production, I played Marianne Dashwood. Sense and Sensibility was an amazing collaboration between Folger Theatre and Folger Exhibitions. While we were doing Sense and Sensibility on stage, there was a once-in-a-lifetime exhibition called Will and Jane, Shakespeare, Austen, and the Cult of Celebrity, on display in the Great Hall. For any lover of Jane Austen, this rare moment in Austenland was a wonderful time that brought her words delightfully from the page to the stage all in one place. To catch you up on where we are and what you are about to see. Dire financial straits have forced the Dashwood family, my mother, two other sisters, Elinor and Margaret, and me, Marianne, to move to a distant cottage. While in the country, I meet and fall in love with John Willoughby. The scene you are about to see is where our once clandestine romance is revealed to all. Sense and Sensibility at the Folger was an extraordinary event, and we are so very pleased to be able to share it with you again. Please be sure to join us for these weekly episodes of Encores, highlighting all that the Folger has to offer. Thank you.
Well, despite our reduced numbers, we must make ourselves merry. What do you all say to a ramble after dinner? A short moonlit drive through the country.
Ask Mr. Willoughby and Miss Marianne about drives in the country.
Ma'am?
I have found you out in spite of all your tricks. This morning when we all went driving and you two sped away out of sight, I made my woman inquire of your groom, sir, and I know where you spent the morning.
Yes. Out in my carriage.
Yes. Yes, Mr. Impudence. And I know where you went in that carriage. I hope you like your future home, Miss Marianne. And I look forward to visiting you at Elinor.
A good drink on us, Willoughby.
Marianne. Did you really visit Alan with Mr. Willoughby?
Yes!
With no companion other than Mr. Willoughby?
We did not do anything wrong, Eleanor. Mr. Willoughby has a perfect right to share that estate. It will all one day belong to him.
Even if Alan was one day to belong to you, Marianne, you would not be justified in what you have done.
Eleanor?
Why didn't you tell me?
Why don't you talk to me about Edward?
There is nothing to tell.
Then the same is true for me. There is nothing to tell, Eleanor. We took a little stroll. Perhaps it was rather ill-advised of me to go without a chaperone or a formal invitation. Willoughby wanted particularly to share me privately. There is the sweetest little garden there.
No news of an engagement yet?
I cannot think why he uses her Christian name quite openly.
Such an extraordinary silence.
An establishment may not be within his power until he inherits.
Well, he certainly lives expensively.
All fashion and no fortune, as they say.
Well, no announcement of their attachment yet. Why such secrecy?
Why such secrecy?
Why such secrecy?
Why such secrecy?
Lock of her hair.
How do you know?
I know many secrets. Eleanor.
Margaret.
I saw him take it. Last night after tea, when you and Mama went out of the room, they were whispering together. And he took up the scissors and cut off a lock of her hair and kissed it and put it into his pocketbook. And today she asked to stay at home alone. I'm sure that he must be visiting with her now.
Margaret?
And if Mr. Willoughby's coming outside, I told you he did move the tower.
Yeah. Is anything amiss?
Yes, there's been a very heavy disappointment.